Hey everybody, Muscle Wes here in Skunk Works, where we craft and assemble the American Muscle Grill. Today, I'm going to do a brief description on how we actually fill the muscle grill for grilling. Now, of course, the American Muscle Grill is a gas grill, and if that's all you want to do, you can cook on natural gas or you can cook on LP. If I were to do that, I would simply leave these empty without any solid fuel. I'd put this down, I would start my grill, and I'd turn on as many of the burners as I would need to complete that cooking on natural gas. But of course, anybody that bought this grill is probably excited about the fact that we can do multi-fuels. And what I mean by that is we can put in charcoal, we can burn lump coal charcoal, we can burn wood, and we have a field-friendly unplug-and-play infrared burner as well. But let me show you what we will do, and I'm going to show you just briefly how the grill works itself. I'll lift the grate with the grate lifting tool, and just a little anatomy of the grill. These are our flavor trays. These are solid, they're heavy. Underneath the flavor trays, just so you can see what's going on, the simplicity of the grill, we have our burner. We have five burners. Each burner is 22,000 BTUs, and we also have a burner cover. Burner cover, of course, protects the burner, keeps it from greases, oils, and things that come off on your cooking. But as you can see, we also have the ports down below because we're going to use those to empty the grill of all the solid fuel once we're done. So we put the burner cover over, put our flavor trays or fuel trays on top, and I'm going to decide I'm going to cook on three fuels. I can fill all the trays up, or I can fill one or two. If I want to be simple and cook a couple of steaks, I can fill one tray or two trays with either charcoal, fuel, wood, etc. If I'm cooking for a large amount of folks, I'm cooking more food, I'll fill more. First thing I wanted to do is just show you the charcoal. I've got about 2.5 quarts of charcoal here. I'm going to fill these two trays with charcoal. Keep it simple. I do not want my charcoal to go over the level of the flavor fuel trays. That's all the charcoal I will need right there. If I were to do lump coal, I would simply come over here, throw my lump coal, which is ignites faster, it burns hotter, it doesn't smell, has no chemicals in it whatsoever. And if I run out of fuel and I want to add while I'm barbecuing, I can always add more fuel without messing up the taste of what I'm doing. So I keep that fairly low. The next thing is wood chips. You can do this as well. I usually soak my wood chips because they last longer. They don't flare. They kind of get a nice ember to them. Smoke comes off. So I will take wood chips that I've soaked in water, and I'll simply put them in this tray here. I'll pull this down, I'll come over, I've got a two-step activation knob as far as our valve's concerned. All the valves are underneath the burner, so this area of the grill will always stay cool. I'll come over, I'll have LP or natural, I'll start it, start maybe this one, and I'll start this one, and within 3 minutes, my fuels will ignite because of the gas flame underneath. Once it's ignited in about 3 minutes, I'll turn off all my valves and I'll be cooking on solid fuels. These fuels will be ready. I could start throwing food on here in probably about 7 or 8 minutes after it's heated. So that's the simplicity of the grill. The nice thing about the American Muscle Grill is after you get done cooking, all this is going to be expended. It's going to be a very fine ash. We've designed this when it's cooler by simply shaking the fuel trays. You'll find that the spent ash will fall right through and come into our collection tray or our oil tray, drip pan, whatever you want to call it. It'll fall through there, and I'll simply pull this out and I'll dump this. This is very heavy duty. It won't fall out and fall on your shoes, and that's how we do it. So that shows you how you fill it, how you light it, and how you clean it afterwards.